My name is Vahid Chitsos for Elite Mastermind Group. Go ahead and introduce yourself to everybody. Let us know where you're tuning in from.
Hi, my name is Jaleesa Medina. I do live videos called Jaleesa Mindset Minute. I am from Leominster, Massachusetts.
Awesome, awesome. I saw your video yesterday. You were killing it. I don't know why you said you want to be a public speaker one day. You were doing public speaking right there anyway, so it's all good. But I know your emphasis is on thinking grow rich. I know you're a big fan of Bob Proctor, and you do have a few mentors. So let's dive into thinking grow rich. What is the first topic we want to discuss today?
Well, desire, because it's the first chapter. And people sadly don't have that burning desire, and it's because of their limited beliefs. And I limited myself for so long, but thankfully I learned to love me back in 2016 before I took the stage for my first competition, and because I'm a fitness competitor, and I believed in myself, and I had this burning desire to achieve what I wanted to achieve for 10 years. And I didn't limit myself anymore. I said, you know what, I'm gonna do this. And sadly I had some family and friends who didn't believe in me. And some people allow other people's opinions to prohibit them from moving forward, but I chose not to. I chose to move forward, and I'm blessed and grateful that I was able to do it, because I've done six competitions, well, actually seven competitions since 2016.
That is awesome. So why would somebody want to stop you from doing that? What would be the, I don't see any reason, if that's what you want to do, you want to be in fitness and you want to compete, why would somebody say no?
Well, I think it's their own paradigms. Their own programming of what they believe. And because I couldn't go out with them and engage in conversation and go to parties or go to the beach because I was training. So it's like that, I don't know if you know this analogy, when a crab is in a bucket and one crab is trying to get out and the other crabs are trying to bring them back down. And that's what happens with too many people, because they don't believe in themselves. They allow the crabs to pull them back down. I chose not to.
So how do you go from fitness to public speaking? How do you connect those two? Tell me what the rationale is.
Well, I decided this past year that because I learned to love me, and I've been on this journey of personal growth and personal development since 2016, I decided I wanted to inspire others to never give up on their dreams. And in order to get over the fear of public speaking, I needed to start doing live videos. And my tour this past year, I'm part of this mastermind with like-minded people that are actually globally. He suggested I start doing Facebook Lives. And not only just do it one day a week, he suggested every day. And I'm thinking to myself, I can't do it every single day. That's scary. But then I was allowing fear to prohibit me from doing it. And then I just implemented, I started one day a week, 2 days a week. And I think now I do it 5 days a week, and I'm becoming better at it. And I feel as if me doing this, I foresee myself next year being up on stage in front of thousands of millions of people, sharing my journey and inspiring others to never give up on their dreams, to continue dreaming and not allowing other people's opinions, their past or their age, define them, because I'm 44 years old and I limited myself.
You mean 24, right? Okay, 20. That sounds about right. That sounds about
right. I'm
but here's my question. I think like you're cheating though. You're doing your live sessions in the car before you go to the gym. So I don't know about that. That's kind of cheating to me. You're not doing it at your house. You're not doing it at your office. Right before you go to the gym and you have it in the car and it's always tilted to the left. So we see someone, it's cool. It's all right. But I kind of think like you're cheating. You're just doing it right before the gym. You're like, if it's bad, I can work it out. It's cool. I'm cool. It's all right. Before you do cardio, I guess you got to do one public speaking. I mean, if that's your thing, I'm cool with it. There's nothing wrong with it.
No, you know what? Whenever I feel it is when I do it.
Is that most of the time in the car? Is that what it is?
Well, I don't know. It's just if I'm feeling something, even if I'm always wearing a baseball cap when I do my lives. I love that, my black baseball cap. And you know what? Last night I didn't. I was all kind of dressed up.
I'm sorry. So here's my question. Let's say there's somebody watching this video today and they have a fear of public speaking. And I don't mean just by public speaking. Let's say you have a message. Let's say you have something that you need to verbally convey to other people. You need to communicate it outside of you. And you have the fear of putting on a video. What would be a couple of steps that I can take to get over that fear? Because for all of us, it's easy to say, oh, you got to get over your fear. You just got to do it. But I think there is more to it. So how would I do it?
So the opposite of fear is faith. Having faith in yourself. Believing in yourself. And what I've learned is writing down what you desire. Writing down your goals. So if you desire to be a public speaker or to do Facebook Lives, writing down your goals, but putting an end date to it. But not just, and when you put an end date, what are you going to do to give back to others? Because I don't just do these Facebook Lives just to do it. I do it to provide content, to give back. And when you write down your goals, such on a goal card or in a journal, write it down, read it every day, twice a day. But not just read it, feel it, envision it. Put it into your subconscious mind, which controls your body. Feel that energy vibrating throughout your body. And you know what? Once you reprogram that mindset, that your subconscious mind, those habits, you're gonna see so much abundance coming into your life. And for me, I don't just write down my goal cards. I read it every single day. I have a vision door. So vision door, not a vision board. So I would suggest implementing tools that'll help you and motivate you to get to where you want to be. If you have this fear of public speaking, start out small. Get in front of a school, or probably that's a little too much, but do a Facebook Live. Provide content that will not only inspire others, but will motivate you to want to do it.
So how would I come up with my content? Do you just go randomly go and pick a topic and you talk about, or do you have a specific topics that you go, okay, on Monday I'm going to talk about this, or do you get inspiration by just going through your daily routines and life, and then what happens, you're like, oh, I got to share this? Because a lot of people get stuck at, okay, I'm going to do a live, I'm on the live, but what do I say? Where's my content? What am I talking about? Or where do I start? What do I end it with?
So there's several things that I do. For instance, I write in a journal at night and I write in a journal in the morning. I write it. This isn't my journal for the morning. I write a letter to myself every single day about positive affirmations, what I'm blessed and grateful for. And sometimes I go on lives and read a journal entry and I'm sharing with others how I'm feeling. So that is one content. Other things, it's just, I'll take like what's going on in my personal life. I'm learning to be more transparent because a lot of people have dealt with issues in their past, like myself, and that limited me to move forward. I mean, I've dealt with depression, eating disorder. There's a lot of things that have transpired. I haven't been very open to certain other things, which I eventually will, because I plan on being on stage, so I have to be open to everything so I can help others. So this is content that I provide. In addition, my coach, my mentor, he provides content, live content Monday through Friday. So sometimes I'll take a little of what he's saying and I implement it in my lives and relate it to my personal life.
Got it. So here's my other question, which you already touched up on. How important is it for individuals to be part of a mastermind group, or how important is it to have a mentor? I think having a mentor comes first before a mastermind group. But what is your opinion on being part of a coaching session where you have someone that's keeping you accountable? Why is that important?
I think because I had never had a mentor before. I had never looked up to someone who inspired me to be the best version of myself. And this past year, I decided to sign on with a mentor. I think it's important to have a mentor, most importantly than a mastermind group. But with my mentor, it incorporates a mastermind group as well. He has, because of his growth with Bob Proctor, and he's his number one consultant, he has learned to change his paradigms and now lives a life of wanting to service others. And I want to serve others. I want to inspire others, especially people who have dealt with things that I have dealt with in my past. And so that they realize we all have the potential to achieve anything we put our mind to achieve success. And look at Oprah Winfrey. Oprah Winfrey, if anyone doesn't know her story, she was raped. She went through it all, but she didn't allow her past to define her. She had a burning desire to achieve a dream she had set for herself, but she took action to it. And she had faith in herself, and look at where she's at. So one of my, it's on my vision door, is to meet Oprah Winfrey one day, because I would love to know more about her, and she's inspirational.
We actually share the same birthday, so I mean, listen, send her a message on Instagram. Her team might see it, and you let her know that it's very, very important for you to meet her. But I understand that these individuals, they're extremely busy, they're in demand, and they're running a big, huge company which employs a lot of people. So I understand that. But what I love about social media and what's going on today, we're very lucky and blessed that all of these individuals can put their content out there. So we may not get one-on-one session with them, but at least we'll find out their stories, what they have done, what are the struggles are, and what are the key elements that made them successful. They talk about it. I mean, Oprah is very vocal about all these things. I mean, there are hundreds of videos that you can watch there, but I understand it's a kind of a treat to meet them in person, to actually connect the videos with the person. It's all good. So my last question for you, if somebody has not read the book, Think and Grow Rich, why should they pick up the book and read the book?
Well, they don't, first off, there's Audible too. Some people don't have the time to read books, so they can listen on Audible. I listen to books while I'm at the gym. I don't listen to music. And why they should pick up, are you referring to this book?
Right there, that's the one. I got the bigger one because this is a little bit different than the other one, but that's my favorite cover. It's a small compact, and I studied that one for like almost 10 years. That was one of my favorite. The 21st century updated version, I think some of the vocabularies have been updated, so it makes it easier for individuals to read it, especially in this day and age. But why should they read it?
I think it will reprogram their subconscious mind and realize that they have the potential to achieve success, because a lot of people, as I stated, they don't have that burning desire. They don't have the persistence. And doing that, reading this, could help them not only with themselves, but with their personal lives, relationships, their businesses, financially, wealth, mindset. It could help them to grow. I bumped into a gentleman while I was working at Starbucks, and he owns his own company. It's a recyclable straws and recyclable K cups and so forth. And he had, I mentioned about his beautiful vehicle that was outside. And he said, well, I got that vehicle because of the book, Think and Grow Rich.
Wow.
He read that book numerous times, and it changed his thought process. It made him believe in himself. But not only this book doesn't make you just believe in yourself, it being around like-minded people who are reading this book, who aspire more, who want more, who desire more, will help you to where you want to go and what you want to achieve and what your passions and what your dreams are. If you dream to be wealthy, if you dream to own this vehicle or to own a house or to travel the world or to be a published author, like I'm looking to publish my children's book. And that's one of my C-type goals. It scares me, but I envision it happening next year.
I have no doubt you're going to do fantastic. You're on the right path. I've been watching the live sessions. Hopefully you end up doing more live Instagram, because Facebook is a little bit for a more mature market. Hopefully you start doing more Instagram lives. And what I like about it is you keeping it authentic and you telling everybody the way it is, because a lot of people outside, when they do it, they're not keeping it authentic. So I think that resonates with a lot of people, especially when you're talking about current things that are happening with you and the way you feel. So I'm very proud of you. Keep up the good work. Looking forward to doing more videos with you.
Likewise. Thank you so much. And I appreciate you. And happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.